Well, that was cool. Let's go to Shuttle Bay. I'm not gonna mess with my weapons. What? How much money do I have? I have plenty of money, right? Yeah, I'm not wearing collector armor. I'm gonna get one of these, though. Things don't want to. Terminus armor. It's got melee damage, ammo capacity, and shields. Blood dragon armor. Power recharge, speed, power damage, and shields. With the Dragon Age logo. Pretty cool. So far, really good with your powers and such. Is that Canela? Oh, yes. Serta? There was nothing there. Omega gel upgrades? I guess we got them all. Casa fabrication. Inferno armor. It's like Iron Man. Power recharge, speed, and damage. 30% each. Doesn't help with shields. Agar munitions. Nothing there. Spectre requisitions. Can't afford. Separatine armory. Elkos combine. Cerberus armor. Ammo capacity plus 10%, weapon damage plus 20%, shields and health. I think I'm gonna get this. Cerberus assault armor is designed for shock troops who are expected to turn the tide of battle against creatures or forces that would decimate normal soldiers. The troops demanded three things in its design: shields and armor thick enough to last against a superior foe, and compartments for extra thermal clips. The only drawback of the armor is its weight. Oh, really? Which the troops carry as a point of pride. They have a saying, out of shape going in shape coming out. Is it going to increase my weight? Blood Dragon. Originally created for Earth's Urban Combat Championship League, this set of armor has undergone as much or more field testing as those of modern militaries. It uses a unique proprietary power cell that costs as much as EUCC rookie's contract. The armor's microframe computer adapts to any top-tier Omni-tool, kinetic barrier, or biotic amp, giving breathtaking and error-free performance. The chest and shoulder piece bears the logo of the Edmonton Blood Dragons, and the inside of the armor bears the signatures of the entire team. They sign the inside of the armor. So, I'm gonna save, because I want to make sure. Can't even see it here, can I? I want to make sure it doesn't increase this. Power recharge speed is minus 106%. Now that I got it down there, I don't want to really increase it if I don't have to. It's just what they said about the weight. I forgot which one had it. Cerberus. always prepared. 1 out of 2. Item purchased. I can't. What? Interesting, I can't drag this down. I'm hoping this doesn't increase my weight while I'm wearing it. It says something about it, but I can't. None of these stats reflect that. Of course now, I can't use all the goodies I found. I found something new for shoulders, didn't I? Anarchy technologies. Shoulder plating with micro servos that coordinate melee strikes. I guess I think it was. Cerberus armor. And the weight looks the same here, but probably because I'm not wearing the armor? I don't know. For better or for worse, we'll find out.
The munitions you carry into the field deserve at least a triple check.
Okay.
Ma'am.
Out of my way, robot dog. I have to run over here so this guy will just say, hey.
Rachni? Of all the things that... It's like you got the opposite of a horseshoe up your ass.
Grunt is crazier than you, and that's saying something. You're better looking, at least.
Well, thanks. Better looking than Grunt, that's good.
Do you hear that hum? Is that just me?
No, it's... here in the...
Do you hear that hum? Is that just me?
No, it's really here in the hangar. It's called equipment. Engineering. Oh, all engineers are present. Let's go visit Diana Allers first. Is she this way? I forget which way. But she is, 3, you know, back the other way.
Can't do a story that's as classified as it gets.
I suppose it would cause a panic, but wouldn't the news drive up recruiting?
It might also piss off a Krogan with diplomatic immunity. No thanks.
Haha.
Commander.
Allers. Alright, let's check up in our engineers. How are these guys getting along with each other?
She is the Normandy.
No, she's a passenger in the Normandy, just like us. The ship was a spacefaring vessel before Edie even existed.
Engineer Donnelly is correct. The Normandy SR-2 was completely spaceworthy prior to my installation.
See, Edie agrees with me.
Edie's mind and the Normandy are a whole entity now. You couldn't just move the processors in the AI core to another ship.
Engineer Adams is correct. Processes that contribute to my self-awareness are spread throughout the ship.
See? Edie agrees with me.
But unlike Edie, our brains couldn't have existed without our bodies.
That is a requisite from being organic. You have to look beyond that limited definition of life.
Joker pilots the Normandy. He doesn't take over Edie's body when he does that. When Edie controls the ship, she's piloting, just like Joker.
Edie doesn't pilot the Normandy. She is the Normandy.
No, she's a passenger in the Normandy, just like us. The ship was a space-faring vessel before Edie even existed.
Engineer Donnelly is correct. The Normandy is...
Oh, they're going to keep looping endlessly.
Prior to my installation.
Guys, guys.
The Normandy is a ship. Edie is a collection of processing hardware contained in that ship. Those are two separate things.
Doesn't the existence of the Reapers contradict that?
So what do you think, Edie?
Are we more than our thoughts?
I'm done. Any more of this and my head's going to explode.
What do you think, Daniels?
Adams would like to speak to you.
That's what you think, huh?
You should go see Adams, Commander.
Okay, Adams, I heard you want to speak with me.
Commander, remember the problem I mentioned? About a core overload possibly venting into the engineering compartment?
Right.
Daniels, Donnelly, Edie, and I have been brainstorming and comparing notes.
And arguing.
You see, the venting occurs when IES sinks are in a back cycle. At the same moment, the main core is at peak draw, such as from sustained kinetic...
What?
What Kenneth means to say is that we're pretty sure we can make the system safer.
We just need a GX-12 thermal pipe. Unfortunately, we're cut off from Alliance supply chains. Could you keep an eye out for one the next time you're on the Citadel, Commander? I've got the specs right here.
Yeah. Why do we need it again? In layman's terms?
Are these modifications really necessary?
It's a safety issue, not exactly critical. Under extreme conditions, like heavy bombardment to the kinetic barriers while traveling at peak flight speeds, plasma can vent into this compartment.
Mm. It would vaporize anyone standing in this room.
Yeah.
That sounds more serious than just a safety issue.
Mm-hmm. Well, under those conditions, odds are you're about to lose the entire ship anyway.
But we want every advantage we can get, right?
She's pretty. I'll buy it.
I'll look for one the next time we go to the Citadel.
Thanks, Commander.
No problem.
Need anything, Commander?
There's some new options here. I don't think these were here. Donnelly?
How's Engineer Donnelly working out?
The kid's got talent. Now if he could just learn to shut his damn mouth.
Problems?
I'm sorry, Commander. Donnelly is dedicated, knowledgeable, and thinks on his feet. I'm glad to have him on my team.
Good.
Could use a lesson or two about respecting chain of command, but I've handled the likes of him before. No need for concern.
And, Engineer Daniels?
How's Engineer Daniels working out?
Her, I like. She's sharp and knows propulsion theory better than most physicists I've met. And she's easy to work with, too. Always said you had an eye for talent. Good job bringing her back to the Alliance.
And she's not hard to look at, either. And Edie?
What do you think of Edie?
We had a good talk during the retrofit. A little strange at first, talking shop with an AI.
Yeah.
AI? I thought Edie posed as a VI to keep the likes of you from unplugging her.
Yeah, this before.
Yeah, but I saw through her. Have you seen... And then there were the problems that kept fixing themselves.
If you never expressed any skepticism, Lieutenant Adams.
I figured I'd better play it safe with the Cerberus AI, Edie. No offense.
None taken. As long as you keep your fingers out of my cognizance processors.
Nah.
In the beginning, I tried disconnecting her from key processes without giving myself away. Easier said than done. But Joker seemed to trust her. And in time, I saw her advantages. Even grew to like her.
Okay.
Carry on, Adams.
Aye, aye, ma'am.
Not completely sure. Okay, we got journal update for the pipe. But I think the Edie parts of the conversation are new. Could be wrong, though. I definitely remember what he was saying. Now that I don't have to talk to Daniels...
Sometimes keeping the grid balanced is pure murder.
I mean Adams.
Power grid is in the green. Power grid is in the green.
Commander.
All right. Many quests. Chief Engineer Adams has requested a GX-12 thermal pipe to make the Normandy's engines safer. Find one on the Citadel and deliver it to him. All right. The only place I haven't gone is the crew deck.
Mm-hmm.
Garrus. Computer, locate Garrus. Oh, he's in the lounge. Is this the lounge? 7. Oh, the lounge is down there. Okay. He's moving. You're not supposed to move around.
Wasn't the first time I faced Ragnheim.
Really? You've seen them before?
Copeland.
A few years back, on Novaria, Saren and his minions were trying to extract information from the Ragnai Queen.
You saw the Queen?
Hell, we spoke to her.
You spoke? I can't imagine that. The things you've done, sir, they're amazing.
Well, it didn't seem that way at the time. Mostly, you're just clawing your way out of one mess and into another, hoping your ass comes along for the ride.
Hmm.
Just one word, Shepard. Grunt. There'll be a lot more dead Reapers now.
True. Well, unfortunately, you can't just punch them.
Siding with the giant spiders again, huh, Shepard? Let's hope this finally pays off.
Yeah, I hope so.
Most people have never even seen Arachni. The Normandy? We're a regular safari tour.
Nah. The lions, the tigers, the bears. Oh my.
If I never see another spider again, I'll die a contented Turian. Unless they have spiders in the afterlife. Damn. Maybe later.
Okay, let's check in on Liara. She probably won't have anything new because we just talked to her. But we might have some.
Have found any new engineers for the Crucible Glyph?
5 Exonex Industries scientists who attempted to reverse engineer Prothean technology stolen from planet Garvok. They are technically still wanted by the Council for hiding Prothean technology. As well, Sonax is part in instigating an illegal war on Garvok.
I'm sure the Council will forgive that for helping with the Crucible. Extend those scientists amnesty and an invitation.
Right away.
Cool. I didn't think there'd be anything new.
I've never seen Krogan move with such purpose. It's a little terrifying. Thanks for coming by.
Try to get a good look at people's faces when they talk. So this is an upgrade. This is an upgrade that we already have then. Okay. Audio log. Grunt addresses new Aralak company recruits. Okay, so we have more Aralak company, so that's how they're an asset. Got it. Recruit says, still don't understand why they put a tank-grown freak in charge of a whole company. Grunt laughs. And I don't understand why they gave me whining piejacks for soldiers. I have more years on the battlefield than you have kills, Rent. Trying to mate with Salarian females doesn't count as fighting. No one talks to... Grunt says, someone help him up. We move in an hour. Email from Dr. Locke to Admiral Hackett. Security almost opened fire on the Ragnai when their ships pulled up to the Crucible, Admiral. I had to invoke your name more than once before they were let on board. They're following instructions, but my God, do I have to tell you how nervous everyone on the project is to see Ragnai strutting down the halls? They almost gave Professor Leo a fit. I'll let you know how our next staff meeting goes, Dr. Locke. Interesting.
A pleasure to see you.
Why, thank you. Alright, let's check in on our friends here. Who's... We got Mordin and the female Krogan, Dr. Chakwas. Oh, Dr. Chakwas is in cruise quarters.
Doctor, I'd like to hear the song.
What?
Again? Trying to calculate amino acid decay rates.
You said you would once the tests were done.
Are you gonna sing the modern...
Better to die to a thresher maw with shotgun blasting roaring raw than to play ambassadorial games with the blood of Chiaga in her veins. Off to fight since Turians can't with diplomats instead of a crant, but she'll be true to Duchanka's dream and live and die a Krogan queen. For she is the Krogan queen. Hurrah, hurrah for the Krogan queen. It is a glorious thing to be the Krogan queen. Still prefer patter songs.
Patter songs.
I really had to twist your arm.
So funny. That was hilarious. It's still... I thought he was going to sing... I am the very model... I am the very model of a scientist Salarian, etc. That's the best. Can't top that.
Something else, Commander?
It's the same. Mordin. She's growing more fond of Mordin. Wonder if she'll have a different answer? I don't know.
How has Mordin been treating you?
Better than Krogan males do. He's not like a typical Salarian.
No. Organ redundancy results in new period before metaphase. Can't alter that. Damage to telomeres, premature aging.
He does that.
But I sense pain in him, too. He told me about his work on the genophage. I should consider him an enemy. Yet I think seeing my sisters and I changed something in him.
Sorry, Borgia offspring have an allergy to dairy and...
Well, it wasn't his ear.
I think that's the same reaction, so...
Thanks for talking to me.
It's my pleasure, Commander.
I want to know why she's all covered up like that. Oh, reassign power bonuses. Reassign powers. Reset Shepherd's powers. Flare. Can I use all these? Lash? Oh, one at a time? Did I just waste money, though? 39,800. Oh, God. I just wasted, like, 10,000, didn't I? I have Flare. That's the one I want. I thought I could just keep buying them. Item purchase flare, lash, flare, oh my god. Mordin.
Shepard, Eve ready for travel to Tuchanka.
Tell me about the Shroud.
What can you tell me about the Shroud?
Climate regulator. Counteracts radiation damage to Tuchanka's atmosphere from nuclear war. Particles emitted from main tower form layer that mitigates ultraviolet bombardment, prevents atmospheric escape of necessary elements.
It was Salarian work?
And your people put it up?
Yes, when uplift process began. Demonstration of goodwill to Krogan, stabilize climate, impress population. Combined with technological gifts, easy to gain Krogan support against Rachni.
What are your feelings about the data?
So we did the right thing by saving the data?
Indeed. Would be much harder to treat Eve without it. Maybe impossible.
And all those experiments we saw back on Tuchanka?
Monstrous, repulsive, but now with purpose. Victims didn't die for nothing.
This is familiar. I'm just going to continue, though.
So the end justifies the means.
Not my means.
But you're using the data, encouraging more experiments like Malin's.
Encouragement irrelevant. We'll always be scientists willing to perform unethical tests. Can't change that. But can help Eve. Can cure genophage. Won't ignore data vital to her survival because of unethical origins.
How's she doing?
No fever currently. Heart rate elevated. Likely stress. Eating appropriately. Could use another blanket. Something soft. Prefer to let her recover fully before synthesizing cure. My medical recommendation.
My people don't have time for that.
Her opinion, somewhat different.
You care about her?
My patient. My responsibility. Found her at STG base. Three doctors injured trying to restrain her. Undid arm restraints. Didn't resist when she grabbed me. Promised to help her. She said, please.
Hmm. Alright. Pretty sure all that's the same.
Nice talking with you, Mordin.
We'll be here if you need me. Continuing to study Shroud in meantime.
Okay. Let's check in with a good doctor. In here, I think.
Commander.
Okay. Let's hang out here by a bunk. We have a couple entries to read. Why not just end the episode doing that? We have new stuff under primary as well. Planets and locations.
The John Grissom T'Chanka. Academy founded T'Chanka, the Krogan homeworld, boasts extreme temperatures, virulent diseases, and predatory fauna. Around 1900 BCE, the Krogan discovered atomic weapons and promptly sent their planet into a nuclear winter. The majority of the population retreated to underground bunkers, and Krogan culture slipped into a dark age, dominated by tribal clans. In 80 CE, decades into the Rachni Wars, the Salarian Union made first contact with the primitive Krogan and initiated a cultural uplift to shape them into a modern army capable of confronting the Rachni. During this uplift, the Salarians constructed the Shroud facility on T'Chanka to shield the planet from harmful forms of solar radiation. Later, during the Krogan rebellions, reproductive rates were curtailed by the genophage, ensuring the Krogan remained a species in decline and T'Chanka a desolate wasteland.
Mm-hmm. Technology.
Biotics is the ability of rare individuals to manipulate dark energy and it may be possible to reverse the genophage by extracting an immunity from the genetic data of a cured Krogan female. A Salarian geneticist named Malin, a former student of Dr. Mordin Solis, discovered the cure through unethical experimentation on live subjects. The complexity and durability of the genophage derives from biochemical countermeasures that the Salarians wove into the plague in an attempt to make the sterilization incurable. No one is certain of how Malin circumvented the countermeasures, but his work was complete enough to allow replication of his results. In its original form, the cure restored fertility but severely compromised the immune system. This resulted in slow, painful death for all but one of Malin's test subjects. If the beneficial aspects of the cure can be isolated, a specially tailored virus could repair the affected genes in other Krogan.
That would be awesome. Alright, secondary. Planets and locations. Benning. Benning was once a thriving human colony, but the Reapers have rounded up a large portion of the populace for processing. Some pockets of civilian resistance still elude the Reapers, however, and rescue attempts are underway. A quote-unquote resistance radio, established during the early days of the attack, continues to broadcast, exhorting survivors to band together and discussing rumors of safe havens. Unfortunately, those rumors have begun to result in ambushes, increasing the desperation of those who remain free. Through all this, Benning's automated agricultural systems have continued to operate, leading to unprecedented stores of food in the planet's granaries and warehouses. Yeah, I think we're going to make that our next quest. As they need some help. Technology. The Shroud. What the Krogan call the Shroud is a technological remnant of the Salarian uplift. After T'Chanka's nuclear war released tons of smoke and dust into the atmosphere, the planet temporarily cooled from global dimming, except at the poles where the albedo was lowered by soot. As clouds trapped the resulting heat, enormous swaths of permafrost melted, releasing methane captured in clathrates from previous millennia. This potent greenhouse gas created a runaway heat cycle that was called the nuclear summer. Without intervention, Tuchanka would have sunk into a slow but certain mass extinction. The Solarian solution was to assemble the Shroud, a permanent sun shield of trillions of tiny diffractory lenses placed at the L1 Lagrange point, the point in space where the lens's naturally stable orbit would shade the planet. The Solarian settled on a delivery method that became known as the Shroud Towers. The towers were essentially enormous coil guns that could fire a payload of lenses into space along with the equipment necessary to monitor the payload's trajectories. Many Krogan warlords enthusiastically approved of the plan, some because they believed in saving their homeworld, but most because they saw future military applications for the Shroud Towers. The Shroud was completed on schedule over the next few decades, by which time the Rachni held the warlords' full attention. Oops. The Krogan rebellions were not kind to the Shroud Towers. All but one was destroyed during the push for Krogan demilitarization. The remaining tower, often referred to as the Shroud, even though that is technically incorrect, was repurposed for cloud seeding and atmospheric repair. It remains on the landscape as an anachronism, a symbol of a time when Krogan and Solarians helped themselves by aiding one another. Wow. See how that changed. Alright, we're done here. Elevator. Alright, thanks for watching, everyone. See you in the next episode. And endure. In enduring, grow strong.